Welcome back to another Ele Shop video. In today's video, we'll be comparing four of JBC's most popular soldering tips. The C470, C245, C210, and C115. Known for their exceptional quality, JBC's active tips come in a wide variety of shapes and sizes. But how do you know which tip is suitable for which purpose? JBC is known for its high quality soldering stations, which all work with active tips. There are four series of tips compatible with various tools. The C470 is ideal for heavy duty applications and works with the HDA heavy duty stations. The C245 is for general purpose soldering, while the C210 is for precision work. Both compatible with the modular line and compact line stations. The modular line consists of a broad range of tools, all compatible with each other. So you can combine these tools into a soldering setup, which is exactly tailored for your needs and all controlled from one controller. The compact line is not compatible with other tools, but is very affordable. The C115 is designed for ultra-fine, detailed tasks and works exclusively with the nano stations. We will talk about the details of each tip and their ideal use cases. But first, let me explain some basics about heat transfer, which will be important to understand the rest of the video. You ideally want to select the tip that has the greatest contact area with the soldering joint. A bigger contact area allows for greater heat transfer. The better the heat transfer is, the easier the soldering will be. A lot of our customers want as much power as possible from the soldering station, but a small tip simply doesn't allow the transfer of a lot of power. So in practice, try to use the biggest tip which is practically possible. This will ease soldering. Let's start with the C470. This is one of the largest tips in JBC's lineup. These tips are not used to solder regular PCBs. It's more suited for larger components like antennas. The output can go up to a significant 250 watt, and the largest tip is up to 31 mm. The size means it can transfer a lot of heat, making it effective for bigger jobs, but it's not something you'll use every day. It has its place in specialized tasks. If you look at the different tip shapes available in the C470 series, you'll notice a lot of shapes which look strange at first sight. Take for example the C470 44, which is developed to remove air-off shields. Next up, the C245, which is often considered the go-to all-rounder. This tip comes in a variety of shapes and sizes. From 0.3 to 6.6 mm, it's perfect for medium to fine pitch components and works great for most general soldering tasks, and is compatible with the affordable compact line. Because the smallest tips in the C245 series are only 0.3 mm small, those are small enough for most SMT soldering. And the bigger tips allow up to 140 watt of peak power transfer. So if you're just starting out or don't need anything too specialized, this is the one I recommend. Now let's take a look at the C210. This tip is a bit different. It's narrower and shorter compared to the C245. It is available in a tip diameter of 0.1 to 3 millimeters. This makes it a more precise tool for those who need finer control. Maximum heat transfer is much lower with a peak power of 40 watt. While it might not transfer as much heat as the 245, its smaller size is ideal for tight spaces between SMT components on a board. Last but not least, the C115. This tip is extremely small, with a range of tip diameters from 0.1 to 1 mm, you can only use these for soldering under a microscope. It's very delicate and doesn't have the durability of the larger tips. Think of it as a tool for the most precise tiny jobs, like micro-soldering on the smallest components, like for phones and other delicate repairs. Now let's recap. The C470 is best for larger, specialized components like antennas. Less than 1% of our customers actually need the heavy-duty tips. If you select the proper 245 tip, you will be able to handle most jobs. The C245 is your versatile all-rounder, great for medium and fine pitch work. The C210 offers precision for tighter spaces but isn't as powerful for larger components. The C115 is the smallest, perfect for phones or other delicate repairs. Hopefully this helps you choose the right tip for your needs. For most applications, I recommend the C245. It's available in a range of sizes from 0.1 to 6 mm, making it versatile and ideal for beginners. If you need something more precise, you can step down to the C210 with tip sizes as small as 0.1 mm. If you cannot decide between the 245 and the 210, you can always pick the 245 and add a 210 handle to your setup. By switching out the handle, you can use 210 tips on any 245 station. All of these tips are available on the Elishop website. If you're looking to grab your own JBC tips, check the links in the description below. Have you run into situations where you need a special tip? Let us know in the comments. And don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos.